this morning, and we're going to be having a discussion among us, the three of us. But remember, you can always get to be part of it by heading over to our social media pages. That is Facebook and Twitter, which is Urban Television, and at Urban TV Uganda, respectively. Use the hashtag Urban Today. You can tag me personally on my Twitter. That is at Aina Dash, as well as TinaFierce1 and Willis Daily. Condom use has dropped among us, the youth. First and foremost, I want us to accept that we are youth. Are we?
The two of you are. I'm not.
That's why I said we are youth.
Define youth.
I didn't say we are youth.
Define.
Anyone below 40 years of age. Yes, sir.
40?
Mm-hmm. 40? Kid is not your youth. It could even be 45.
Uh-huh. Okay. That's what I'm saying.
Auntie. Tofa, you're 630 to Natuka. But anyway, economies has dropped. What is going on with our youth? What is happening? Why do you think we're having such cases happening at a particular point in time where we are having these visions of making sure that we fight and kick out HIV as far as 2030 and 2040 is concerned?
Okay, what I'm going to say, I don't know if you all remember, there was a time when the HIV scourge was such a big issue that the whole world held hands to try and fight it. So that's the time we had all these different advertisers and advertisements on TV that had Simanya, the guy wearing the condom, the trousers with the padlock. Then we had, there were so many drives. There would run on television on a daily, and then you would have centerfolds come out and teach kids all about condom use. Now, we have gone to a place where the world assumes by now everyone knows this. Do you get what I'm saying? They are just assuming. I remember there was once a time we was at school and the nurse comes, so this is a condom. This is how it works. This is why we use it. For me, it all goes down to one thing. I don't feel like the sensitization is still there, because everyone, with this world of, it's a fast world, your medical smartphone, they expect you to ask Google, which is wrong. We need to go back to the basics, the old basics. Explain to them why you have to use a condom. Why is it necessary? It's not just for HIV. It is also for this too. It is not just for unplanned pregnancies. It's for this too. I think if the government and us, when you are a candidate people power, but people power, but you get a government, the government and us, it's upon ourselves to actually start to put it into ourselves. Like, you know what? HIV is real, unplanned pregnancies are real, STDs are real. Throw it out there. The more you keep on throwing it, because there is not a single day omana yakulanga alaba UTV. Mujujukira. Now, advert, it was like a 30-minute thing. You would watch it on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. We grew up knowing. But now, it's different. And then the girls learned this whole nonsense of, I am allergic to them.
When I was having this conversation with some mature friend of mine, she actually told me that the problem we have is that the youth we had about 10 years ago are not the same youth we have now. So people have literally moved on, they have matured, they have gotten married, giving them a reason as to why they don't need to use condoms. That the problem we have right about now is that we have not sensitized enough to this current youth as far as, you know, the usage of condoms is concerned. Do you think she was right?
I think she's right in a way. I mean, jokes like instead of the Mbonyes preaching about vaccination, they should probably have condoms at the entrances of their churches. So jokes aside, you know, she's very right in the sense that research has always told us that 78% or 80% of Uganda's population is the youth. But when does that 80% grow? You understand? Of course, it has grown over time. And now we have, I think, more people below the age of 15 years of age. So that is where the huge population is. That's why you can say that the condom use in young people has reduced. Because those guys have grown. They now have kids. They've risked it. Some of them have got AIDS. Some of them have not. And so the condom use, by virtue of the fact that statistics have changed, have to reduce a bit. However, for me, I think that places where youth come together have done us a disservice. If you go to parties for young people, let's say back to school parties, where you have 15 to 25 coming over to attend the parties, these people preach sex through through the songs and music, but they forget to preach how the kids should need to protect themselves against diseases and unplanned pregnancies. So they preach for the kids to go have sex, but they don't help them protect themselves. You will not find condoms at the entrance, but you'll find alcohol at the entrance. So we are substituting some of these things for the most important cause. When you go to churches, pastors are preaching offertory, give us offertory, give us money, give us tithe, give us. But what are you giving back to society?
In
why don't
return,
you? Yeah, why don't you give condoms? Exactly. Most of these churches have youth.
If they give condoms, isn't that like another
fornication.
Way of?
They're going to say
what there's a thin line.
To ban fornication,
yes.
Which is actually against the Bible.
Yes,
oh, no,
there is a very thin
it's
line.
It's among the commandments. You're not supposed to fornicate.
It depends what if I'm
that's
taking,
adultery.
That's adultery. Mm.
But there's also fornication, which
yes.
is also a sin.
Yes.
Yeah, the Bible has many sins you won't keep up. Everything we're doing right now is a sin.
So with or without your condom, you're fornicated.
Yes.
There's a thin line between giving out condoms to protect the youth and giving out condoms to encourage the youth. But you see, when the youth are in church, there's a level of thinking that they have, and they've already instilled in them a spirit of abstinence. Now, this condom is helping the young people that in case you have an issue, in case otende walidwa, abantu batende walidwa bulijjo, no sanga nga church leader, choir leader, nga kubye bulindiga mu church yonna. Manyi bana abajja nakalowozi ne baliding awo. Abaana bali abannange, bano n'ogenda ku mbonya wano ku lw'okubiriyo yabeera. So the churches actually they need to accept that fornication is taking place in churches. But what do we you know castigate these people? Do we you know put them on a mark and say these are sinners are bad? Or do we help them protect themselves against AIDS and other diseases and unplanned pregnancies?
Talking about
the answer is we should
protect,
help them
on top
protect
of the churches. It is not just churches, because there are places that have a good following of people. And when you look at the people that, like you said, the ages of 15, Mpakawansi, or let's cut to Jamusa, 17, Mpakawansi. Churches have to do it. Workplaces have to do it. Schools really, really need to do it. I believe everyone.
Why would the primary school have
not
condoms?
Primary school. Not primary school. But even primary school, it's okay to teach them. Listen, touch tegede. It is okay to sensitize. Temuja kwebuza buzanga
utundewa. Primary.
Tebaba itilanga senior woman teacher ne senior male teacher.
Mu primary.
Primary by P6.
Bali baba igiriza kunaba.
Kwali kunaba.
Bali baba igiriza kwengata.
Ekintu cha condom nzenzi jukira.
Josephine is in studio right now. By what class nyam? Obiera bibi. Batuga
P6 oyine myaka emeka.
Nzenzi jukira ekintu cha condom bwechaso ko kuingilira o. It was during the reproductory topic. In science.
It's
a lesson.
That is the mindset that is taking us behind.
No, because you can't give P6 kids condoms.
What I'm saying is, if we start the sensitization at a much earlier age, we're not going to have issues. Do you know why I'm saying that? Umana amala P7. Nagenda S1. Ngataina chamani. Most girls, chino nchukugamba anga mwala. Most girls actually lose their virginity in senior 1. Most boys will lose their virginity in senior 2.
That's
the hormones zilich.
That's according
Linda
to perception.
Po. Not perception.
Your opinion.
My dear, it's not my opinion.
It's what?
Yeah, as I am a parent.
Do you have research to back up what you're saying?
I know. I talk to these mothers. I talk to
people. I think you should say some, not most.
I want us to come back to the use of condoms. In 2018, there was a report from the Ministry of Health that showed that, you know, the youth had embraced condoms and, you know, they were actually using condoms, and the prevalence of HIV moved from 6% to 7%. In 2019, this particular year, the Ministry of Health has released a report showing a decrease in the usage of condoms. Where is that leaving us as far as fighting HIV is concerned?
Or population itself, not just HIV. Because we are procreating.
I mean, one would argue out
pregnant.
And say that maybe they could use withdrawal. But at the end of the day, they have done, you know.
You cannot have a withdrawal game.
They have had live sex, because that means they have neglected the condom.
Yeah.
Where is that leaving us as far as fighting HIV is concerned?
I think that one, we need to preach use of condoms, but the most important message should be preaching abstinence.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
One is that our young people are idle and disorderly, so they are engaging in sex.
Thank you.
I think we are solving a problem that we should have solved at the initial stage.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Like Tina is saying, you know, instead of going to sensitize a P6, P7 candidate or a vacist in P7, why don't you help them engage in activities that will put their minds off sex? Mm-hmm. So that in S1, S2 is when you're introducing the topic to say, you know what, this is going to happen to you, your body is changing, you're going to do this and this and this. So here is this in case. So for me, I think that Ministry of Health needs to focus on preaching. Number one, abstinence.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, we can preach the condoms because of many factors. One, to control AIDS, to control unplanned pregnancies,
mm-hmm.
and all that. And of course, to curb on the population. And also make these condom factories make money as well. It's one of the factors. But I think that the first message should be abstinence.
Mm.
How do
we make young people abstain?
Okay.
Do you remember back in the day, those are the things I'm still talking about, watching Mwamunga Muchiganya, but you remember that when kids were younger, there was this foundation called Straight Talk Africa.
Yes.
Mm.
And they had a pullout in the New Vision almost every week.
Mm.
That pullout was given to children in every school, every day.
Mm-hmm.
And when you would read that pullout, it was not just talking about shower well, don't smell. No. The biggest part of it was introducing them to having a conversation that parents didn't want to have at home. Parents were scared to talk about sex. And straight that magazine, I remember, it helped so many kids come out and understand, okay, abstinence is good, this is good, this is bad, this is good. Change your bag about that.
No.
We need to go back. What it is, Awilis, we need to go back to the old mechanism because fetwa ita wo. Because we had all those things. Twali tulina TV, sawabina, bakuoga nila, HIV, 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 or condoms, condoms, condoms. It became a song. Netuvaye, you never to wear as a reading material. So as kids, we were preoccupied, the way you're saying. There was a lot for us to do and keep our minds.
But it was about abstinence.
Yes.
It was not about sex.
That's what I'm saying.
Or condoms.
It was about abstinence. Now, what he is saying, he's wondering, what should we do? I'm saying, let's go back to the old format that worked for us when we were growing up. Let us pump these kids with a lot of material for them to understand it. So that by the time someone decides not to wear a condom, it is a personal choice. It is not out of ignorance.
We all understand that the Ministry of Health is largely responsible for the spread of condoms across the country. Now, recently we were having this conversation still about condoms. You know, the condom circulation had reduced. We had few condoms on the market, and we did not even have condoms in our very own government hospitals or even private hospitals. Do you think that one would be right to actually go ahead and blame the Ministry of Health for having neglected its main role of distributing condoms?
They do. How many times do you walk into a bathroom here at work and you see them not to be sold, government property? Bazi gaba. The problem is
tuzikozesa nyone zigwaoma over. Kubanga twali wamu wa rutina. We're discussing the fact that we did not have condoms in the country. Ojukira, you remember that day? Yes.
Kazikubadile obuzibu bwa condom government bwereta. One, our men complained they don't fit.
Mm-hmm.
They are small.
Mm.
Two, our women complain they are made out of cheap latex they can find. They smell horrible. That is one fault. Then you have, now the main one would just plain be, people are just like, Katiazon, because it says a government in fact. Forgetting that because they have not been told that buying condoms is not a problem, ajaga neza government, ateno genda kuduko kusabachi, okuzigula. Now do you understand where the dynamic grows, and I still stick to my word, and I'm like, keep giving these people material to take it in. Because up to today, no grown-up men who will stand at a shop for over 30 minutes so that he can buy a coffee.
Well, that stigma will happen whether people are informed or not. People always have to judge whether you have the information out there or not. If you come to my shop and I'm seeing Derek, you're married. Why do you need a condom? You understand? I'll always judge you like that. There's always that will happen. But for me, I think that, of course, there are factors like stigma, there are factors like, you know, age, you know, if you're buying a condom and you're a young person, people
so,
are saying,
so we
okay,
shouldn't blame the Ministry of Health.
No, you can't blame the Ministry of Health has done its role. They've rolled out these condoms, they've rolled out this information. But I think the problem is now going back to the first unit of the society, which is the family. In your family, as an individual, what are you doing to push the condom gospel? What are you doing to your kids? Are you letting them know that these things exist, but they can't be used now if young kids... If your kids are 16 and above, are
have
you helping them understand that I know you're going to bang at some point, but if you bang, you put it
you
on.
You need one of these.
Yeah. Some parents have issues with having those conversations of, you know, I know you're banging, or I think you're going to bang, or by the way, how are you banging? It's very hard to find a parent to sit down, probably a son, and say, Kati, Derek, I see you putting that kachik on your status. Haven't you thought about
it? What do you do?
The conversation, yeah. Of course, is interesting and would like to have it more often, but unfortunately we have run out of time for that one. We'd like to check out our social media and get to find out what you have to say regarding the drop of uses of condoms amongst the youth. We're going for a very short break, but when we do get back, it will be the second hour of the show and we get into our love letter.